So students, under chapter locomotion and movement, in our last class we have learned till actin and myosin. This picture we have learned in our last class. So already I told you, very important, already we discussed about it, like what is Z line, what is M line, all that I have already explained in last class. Once again we will see what is this, that is, so in between A band, this is where myosin is there, this black color line is myosin, black color, so you see black color, okay. So then wherever this white color, what you see, that is actin. Okay, so in between that, what Z line you can see here, the Z line, this is Z line which is zigzag, that is Z line between two actin, in between two actin there is a Z line, what you see here, Z line, that is this line, okay. And wherever you see this black color, that is myosin, which is white color is actin. Then wherever myosin is there, that is called A band, anisotropic band, and wherever actin is there, that is called I band or isotropic band. No, you already know. Then in between two myosin, there is a space that is called H zone. Already you know this H zone. We have already learnt it. Then region between two Z lines is called sarcomere. This is one Z line and this is other Z line. The region between two Z lines, that is called sarcomere. What you can see here. See, this is one Z line and this is other Z line. Between two Z lines, the space is called sarcomere. What you see there, clearly the picture is showing. Okay, then let us see actin and myosin proteins which are required for contraction and relaxation of muscles. They are also called contractile proteins. Okay, so how they will be exactly? So this is a myofibril, and this red color line what you see is a Z line. In between two Z line, the space is called sarcomere. You see, this is one Z line and this is other Z line. In between that, what area is there? They are showing here. In between those two Z line, it is called sarcomere. In between two Z lines, they are showing how the actin and myosin will be. The blue color thing, what you see, that is actin, blue color. The green color part, what you see, is myosin. The blue color part is actin, and green color part is myosin. Okay, then in between that green color, you can see M line here, M line. Okay, so this is a structure, the same thing they are showing here. Okay, so if you see actin, that is with this blue color part, what you see, that blue color part, that is actin, enlarged view of actin, what you can see here, this is how actin will be. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ದ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್, ಆ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ನ ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಈ ಥರ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್. ಇದೊಂದು ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್, ಒನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ನ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ನ. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಹಿಯರ್. ನೋ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್. ವಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್, ಅದನ್ನೇ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. It will have three parts. The first part is the ball-like structure here. This yellow color, green color or yellow color ball-like structure. Many ball-like structures are there. They are called F-actin. F-actin, that is a monomer. Andre, one on unit, one on ball. Then together it forms a chain-like structure. Okay, then this rope-like structure, what you see here, brown color, that is called tropomyosin. Then here and there you see these three structures, no? See, troponin and troponin, three are there in this. What you see, not continuously, at intervals, illondide, that is called troponin. And troponin is a place where myosin comes and joins actin. There actin matte myosin erdu ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಬೋತ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬೈಂಡ್. ವೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬೈಂಡ್ ಟು ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್? ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ಟ್ರೋಪೋನಿನ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ helicopter cannot be landed everywhere. For landing helicopter, one particular place is required. Helipad, what do we call? ಅಂದರೆ ಹೆಲಿಕಾಪ್ಟರ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಆ ಪ್ಲೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ದೇರ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತುಂಬ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇದೆ ಗೊತ್ತು ನಿಮಗೆ. ದ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ನಾಟ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಇರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಬೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್. ಇಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದೊಂದು ಲಾಂಗ್ ಚೈನ್. ಆ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಚೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ಈಚ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ದ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೋನೋಮರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್. ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಮರ್, ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾಲಿಮರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಚೈನ್ ಅದು. ಹಿಂಗೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಚೈನ್, ಅದು ಲಾಂಗ್, ಸುಮಾರು ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಒಂದು ಚೈನ್. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೋನೋಮರ್, ಮೋನೋಮರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್, ಅದು ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ಸ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಗ್ಲೋಬ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಗ್ಲೋಬ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಮೆನಿ ಜಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ಸ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಜಿ ಸೇರಿ ಒಂದು ಲಾಂಗ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ದೇರ್, ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಸೊ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಾನು, ಟ್ರೋಪೋನಿನ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಇದೆ, 3 ಸಬ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ. ಆ ಟ್ರೋಪೋನಿನ್ನ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ 3 ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ 3 ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್. ಇದು ಇದು ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ನಾನು. ಸೊ ದ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದರ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್, 2 ಚೈನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅ ಹೆಲಿಕ್ಸ್. ಹೆಲಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಥರ. 2 ಚೈನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಿಂಗೆ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದರ್ ದ 2 ಚೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಲಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ದೆನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್. ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್, ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೈಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್. ಇನ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್, ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ. ಇನ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್. ನೋಡಿ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್, ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ನೋ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ರೆಡ್ ಕಲರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್. ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 2 ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೆಡ್, ಅದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಹೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟೇಲ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಹೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಲ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಸಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೆಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಬೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಟ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಬೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೋಪೋನಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ, ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರಲ್ಲಿ 3 ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು, 3 ಬಾಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೋಪೋನಿನ್. ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಬೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬೈಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಬೋತ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬೈಂಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಸಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ದೆನ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಸಲ್ಸ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್. ನೋ ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್. ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಡಿನೋಸಿನ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕರೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮಸ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಬೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಬೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಲೋವರ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಡಾಟ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಬೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಲ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಲ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಮ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಚ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಮ್. ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೆವಿ ಮೀರೋಮಯೋಸಿನ್. ಸೊ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹೆವಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅಗಲ ಇದೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಹೆವಿ ಮೀರೋಮಯೋಸಿನ್, ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಚ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಮ್, ಹೆವಿ ಮೀರೋಮಯೋಸಿನ್. and here myosin will be less, so it is called light myosin. Okay, or LLM, or what we call, not LLM, it is called LMM, that is tail. HMM means heavy myosin, LMM means light myosin. So next, ATP is required, I told you. And the enzyme required for binding of ATP is called ATPase. Simple. If ATP should bind to the ATP binding site of myosin, then ATPase enzyme is required. ATPase. Okay. So you can see here, they are showing both actin and myosin. Okay. So this is myosin and this is actin. Where you see here, this is actin. If you remember the structure, you can recall this, each ball like structure is called G actin, that is globular actin. Many G actins will form a long chain of F actin. Two F actin chains are there in a helix structure. And this blue color, what you see, which has three ball like structure, that is troponin. Andre, this head part of myosin will go and bind to this troponin, that is blue color. Okay, both will bind like this. So the head part of myosin will bind to troponin of actin. Okay, so then only the muscle contraction starts. For if muscle has to contract, at that time the head part of myosin should bind to troponin of actin. Then only contraction of muscles can happen. Let us see what is the mechanism of muscle contraction. There is muscle contraction hegagtade namma body alli nodwa. It is based on a theory called sliding filament theory. Slide agudu andre gottalla nimge, movement agudu. This is actin and this is myosin. It is very clear there, you can see this is actin, what you see here green color, and this blue color is myosin. Okay, so in actin, if you remember, I recall once again, this green ball like structure, what you see, that is globular actin. Many ball like structure together forms F actin, and F actin is a coiled helix structure there. Then this orange color, what you see, that is troponin. Troponin is a place where head part, that is myosin head, joins actin. Not really bind agide. Here the head part is bound to actin, not everywhere, only wherever this troponin is there. See. Okay, so this is a thick filament, this is called thin filament, means which is thick, which is thin. You can see there this blue color line is thicker and this green color line is thinner, so it is called thick filament, this is called thin filament. And what is happening during muscle contraction, you can see, I am contracting my hand now, contracting my muscles. What happened in my muscles? Simple. The head part of myosin goes and binds to troponin of actin. Okay, so you see here what happened there. Here before contraction, this is myosin and this is actin. Before contraction agu kinta munche amela, then what is happening there? ATP will go and bind to head part of myosin, then that myosin head will join actin. See here, so this orange color topmost part is actin and this red color here is myosin. Head part of myosin is bound to troponin of actin, and this purple color, what you see, is ATP. Okay, then if contraction is over, when this is happening, when I contract, when I relax, when it comes back, then what happens? The head part of myosin will, see, I'll show you exactly. It is bound like this. Okay. The head part of myosin will slide like this. It will disconnect. See here, it will get disconnected. When it disconnects, the ATP which is bound, that also will be released, because energy is already used and contraction is already over. See, now I'll show you. Now I have contracted, okay, my hand. This is contraction. When I do contraction, what happens there? The myosin head goes and binds to
troponin of actin, and ATP also binds because energy is required. Then contraction is over, I am relaxing now. When I do this, no, then the myosin head will get disconnected. It is actually moving like this, so it will slide. That is called sliding filament theory. It will slide and ATP will be released because work of ATP is over. Energy already kotta agide, mugitu energy. Enough. Okay, so you can see what exactly is happening there. Okay, this is muscle fiber. During muscle contraction, what is happening there? This is a muscle fiber and this is a neuron. Because whenever contraction happens, message should go to brain. No? So, message to brain goes through nerves. So, this is neuron, you can see here, and this is nerve ending. You already know this. This is the nerve ending and this is muscle, that is synaptic vesicle. Okay, wherever connection is there between nerve ending and muscle, that is called neuromuscular junction. See, suppose this is nerve ending, okay, end part of neuron, it binds to muscles and gap is there, slightly gap, that the joining point of nerve ending of neuron to muscles is called neuromuscular junction. Junction means meeting point. Suppose this is a muscle and this is a nerve ending. Nerve ending comes and binds to muscle. Then that area where muscle binds to neuron is called neuromuscular junction. You can see here. Exactly, they don't touch each other. There is gap. You know always. Even synaptic cleft also you have learnt. No, connection between two neurons. There also completely it doesn't bind. Gap is there. Synaptic cleft. Cleft means the space between those two. Here, muscle, neuron. Because if the muscle should show some action, message should come from brain. See, now I want to contract and relax. That is why, and for contraction and relaxation also, message should come from brain. Brain should say that muscle contraction, relaxation should happen. Because it is under your control, no? Walking, running, moving and movement of any body parts, it is on all your brain controls it because it is under your will. Andre nimge ishta idre matra neevu maadthira, nimge maadbeku anta ansidre matra maadthira. So if you are willing to do, okay, only then you will do it. That means it is under your control. Brain controls it. Suppose now my brain, I am thinking in my head, okay, to show my hand like this. Brain sent a message to do this. So from the brain, message comes through neuron, nerve cells. So that message present in the nerve cell, it will transfer to muscles. That is why with the help of muscles, I show this. Okay. Now, for example, my mind is saying, say Bharat Mata Ki Jai, okay, by showing your hand upwards. I am saying Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Okay. So from the brain through nerves, message comes to muscles. Then muscles will show the action, okay, like that. So neuromuscular junction is required for that process because message from the brain through nerves, it comes to muscles, then muscles will show the action. So you can see same thing what I explained just now. This is nerve ending, then this is muscle, that is neuromuscular junction. You know what happens there. Action potential is generated. You already learnt in neural control and coordination chapter. Message comes from brain through nerve ending, then it will pass it to muscle. Then muscles are effectors. Even in high school also you have learned this, 10th standard. Muscles are effectors, they show action, that is contraction and relaxation. And in between nerve ending and muscle, there is a chemo, what we call neurotransmitters. That is, neurotransmitters are liquid. It's a connection between these two. No, nerve ending and muscle has gap in between. How the message from this will go to this muscle then? Because there is a gap. And the nerve ending igu mate muscle igu gap ide. Hai hagadre nerve in the muscle ge hege message pass aagtade. It will pass through a liquid that is called acetylcholine. And you already know this, acetylcholine, dopamine, serotonin, all these are neurotransmitters, name only says. It will transfer message from nerve to muscle. Okay, and very important thing is calcium ions are required for muscles for to transmit the message and to show the action. Calcium ions, Ca2 plus ions from sarcoplasmic cistern into sarcoplasm. When message comes from nerves to muscle, then muscles will release calcium ions in the cytoplasm of neuron, that is called sarcoplasm. Simple. When message from the nerve comes to muscle, muscle will release calcium ions. So this is what happens, we have already learnt it. So contraction and relaxation, you can see here what is happening. This is a myosin and this is actin. Okay, so first myosin head binds to troponin of actin, then ATP binds to myosin because energy is required, then breaking the cross bridge. That is, this is called cross bridge when myosin head binds to actin. Then already contraction is done, then it will slide, ATP is released. So you can see there. Okay, so this is sliding. It was first straight like this, then it is cross, then it is going this side, then it is completely disconnected because ATP splits into ADP and IP. Means adenosine triphosphate is the one phosphate use aagtade, so two phosphate remains, ADP remains and gets separated. Okay, for muscle contraction it has used one phosphate for energy. Okay, so in our next class we will continue this process. Okay, so keep watching my classes. Thank you.